Hello, welcome back. So apparently the architect is alive again, even though I killed him, ripped the armor from his dead body with his blood on it, and now apparently I know enough information to find out what happened. Yeah, tell me. Sure. Anyway, thank you for your help, especially for your dead armor. I mean, not dead armor, bloodied armor. Have a nice day. Sorry for killing you earlier. Okay, weirdo. Weirdo. Apparently he's immortal, or I'm just experiencing some bugs. Anyway, doesn't really matter. We still have a lot of work to do today, and probably the game, I mean, the developer said the game is about 25 hours long, but I don't believe that. The game is about 50 hours long if you just want to explore pretty much everything. And especially if you want to find out all the weapons and also kind of upgrade all the weapons yourself. Actually, I upgraded this one a little bit, so as you can see, it deals a little more damage right now. 55. Okay, and if you go to the left of here, we'll actually go and meet the weapon merchant. The weapon merchant is the one that makes you weapons from the demons. And then by demons, I mean the big bosses. I always forget to change my cube programs. Nothing here but a pretty sight. So pretty much this area is completely void of anything except for, you know, the path to that guy we're looking for. Yes, what a cute trap we have here. Also, this is kind of like a bad time to explore. What do you want? Are you saying I have to fight? Only two demons, are you kidding me? I eat demons for breakfast. Okay, I don't really eat them for breakfast, but maybe for dinner. That was not such a hard fight. Now, this is the right way to go. Let me see if we can go to the other one. No, nothing. Okay, so this is the only pathway available to us. To demons, huh? And again, I don't really think there is anything hidden in this area, or in these areas. And I find it kind of funny that the demons are actually burning. Now, it says we're traveling to the Arcology, but it's still the Sun District in some way, more or less. So let's go over there. And of course, we'll kick a lot more demons. I would say out of the sky, but it's more out of the space station. So I've been playing around and again reading some lore. Apparently, I don't know, the game is still a little buggy. So some decisions are not permanent. So I don't know if in your game you'll have to kill the architect and he'll be dead forever. But apparently in my game he just resurrected and he's fine as a... Can we go? The architect is just fine as a little boy. Not as a little boy, as a big cyborg, because he's definitely a cyborg. And remember, the Arcology had two sets of elevators, and I think we can open the door right now. Okay, that's the right path to go. Let's see the other way. Yeah, if you want to skip the video, just go along that way. I'll just explore some more. Okay, so this is the elevator door that you can actually access from the Arcology straight up. You know, where the machine is. So ta-da! Well, if you synchronize that portal, I bet you're very happy right now. So this is how you activate the elevator in Arcology, and now we can actually go on our way. Maybe we'll search in the third floor as well, I'm not sure. Why? What's with this station, by the way? Everyone seems like it's made the station just to fall off into space. How about safety? I guess no one really thinks about safety because this was a restricted area anyway. Looks like they're having a party down there. Well, time to crash their party, their demonic party. Well, I think I'll join the demons more or less to get their spells. And if the, well, the architect is still alive, I'll just have to go for the true ending, which has two more bosses instead of one. I mean, it's the same boss as the ending, but it has another one. Hello, little guy. I won't kill you this time, don't worry. Hey, those are my kills! Look at this demon. He stole my kills. Okay, that's some big range you got there. But can you do this? Actually dodge. He could have decapitated me with his kite alone. Also, there is that thing over there, which I don't know what it is, but it looks like an area we can't really access. Let's see if there is a secret over here. No? Nothing? Okay. So I hugged the wall for nothing. Well, that's a waste of our time. So there really is nothing in this area. I don't know why they made it so big and so empty. But I guess we can kill this demon. I mean, he practically... Maybe he feels alone, so let's spread him the misery. Why does he have so much blood? That's disgusting. So this is the Peter human set. Okay, let me see. What did... sorry about that. Peter human. Sorry, I mispronounced that. So let's see how it looks. It probably looks very weird. Well, we barely look human when we are equipping this stuff. Actually, it's kind of cool. I take that back. It's kind of cool. Let's go back into the... Let's slip into something more comfortable and battle ready. I still think this is a Terminator hand and nobody can deny it. Okay, Demon Skite. We are going to make a lot of friends along the way. Especially dead demon friends. Channeler of... Well, wait. Is this the weapon that I've been searching for the whole game? It is! So this is the ranged weapon that you can actually equip. Huh? Did I not equip it? No. It bounces! It really bounces like a ball. Yeah, so this is your first mystic weapon. I mean, this is your first mage weapon. And it throws like bowling balls. Okay, that's just too good to be true. Okay, that was very funny. So that's the first mystic weapon you encounter. So if you want to be a mage, well, I guess you have to go to that place. There is really no way around it. That's a very nice poster, guys. Okay, I guess this is the good way, because we can go back here and we'll see the entrance here. So that way was just the long way around here. Okay, let's make sure we searched everything and everywhere. And good thing there are no more death pits around this place, because I was getting so bored of them. Let's stabilize the bridge, which is not dangerous at all, because we know how to stabilize bridges, apparently. I mean, we were conceived just a few minutes ago. Crafting such bizarre instruments with only a fragment from a cosmic deity. A stego mansion facing alma mater in the high zoom, yet without a view. No, you're up the stairs, probably. Also, we got another item, probably a module for that thing. Was it the catalyst conductor? I really forgot. I'll just have to check the video when I'm done recording. There is just too much going on into the game right now. Too many things to do, too many things to watch. Okay, so let me just take another quick cut here. So I guess this is nothing, we can't really interact with it, but probably we can fall down and die. Okay, so this is the right way to go on the stairs. Let's see if the other stairs lead somewhere else. Wait, why do they have a platform here? Okay, almost fell to my death again. So let's not attempt that. If there is something on that platform, we'll see. That doesn't seem like it's something on the platform. We'll just have to check later. Alma Mater Atrium. Okay, so this is the pathway to the Alma Mater Atrium. Nice. 10 points for House Grim Dark Warhammer. By the way, that's the place of a big boss and some other nasty, nasty stuff. Sorry I'm backtracking so much, but this is why I make timestamps, and also it's still a lot of work, and I hope I can speed up the process or I'll never be able to finish the game. Okay, this leaves me only with the following question. How do I get on that thing, because that's a doorway that leads to somewhere. Probably like this. Okay, so this is only the doorway we came through. Oh no, it's the other one. Okay, I understand now. Just checking. Can't be too sure. I mean, if I had the Breathrail Crown program, it would be a lot easier. But then again, I want more light. What's with this call? Come on, guys. What is this? The Warhammer convention? Warhammer 40k convention? Mind Vessel AS. Oh. I hope you're not eating. I hope you're not eating this guy, actually. Another Mind Vessel. We'll have to check it out a bit later. So this door doesn't open. So looks particularly big.
Promus Motodrimas Vele.
So be careful. Don't kill him. Why? I have no intention of murdering him.
Wiernie zumdrze, prechować wyrcze pechum.
Cosmic Fiorgi?
To drymasz z barli. Pochuć nurny!
So if you kill the bosses, you'll actually craft some things from the fragments. And the fragments, well, he can craft you items like helmets, I think weapons or armors, I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure he can craft armors for you. Well, thank you for all these explanations, but now I have to go back. Okay, almost died. Oh, by the way, let me show you the pitted set, because this is a good idea to make a screenshot. And also, it has a better light in here. Ritter. Okay, I really need to invest some more points so I can wear everything. So this is a reflex set. Okay, I don't want to scare him. This is funny because we're identical humans or artificial humans. As you can see, he still has that double opposable thumb going for him. Okay, so it's nice. Now let's get back into the killing faction, which is the Ivaceta. And that's funny because you're actually cosplaying as an astronaut while killing demons. Okay, let's go down. That's enough fun for today, and I think we still have enough time to listen to the mine cube. Maybe even see what's on the third floor. Actually, I'll keep this video a little shorter and we'll only listen to the mine cube, because apparently the mine cubes contain consciousness of some people or demons or both. Don't want to synchronize that bridge. Oh, hello, you're all spawned again. Oh, that was a funny one. How much experience did I get for my sky? Well, barely any experience. You guys are trash. Continue worshipping that trash. Nothing to be seen here. Something moved. Okay, that thing... Those things, when they move, they kind of scare me, because I think they will... They remind me of the Scarabs from Warhammer 40k. And the Scarabs belong to the Necrons. Why is this here? Apparently, this guy made the decision not to die. Okay, for a moment I was scared because I thought I was going to fall down that thing. Okay, so let's take a quick look at what's at the floor number 3, and then we'll get back to the bottom one and actually listen to the mind. Actually, speak with the mind inside the cube, because they're actually fascinating little minds or demons or humans or... You know, we don't even know what's what in this game anymore. Okay, so this is the third floor where we actually have to align those things with the codes you get. I won. Okay, so you have to, you really have to find all the eyes or just search it on Reddit. So I think if we do this, we can open the gate in the Zone District. Okay, so we found out a lot of information this episode. Sure, I might make a video on that next time, but it will be so boring to wait until that thing opens. Okay. Well, this is a good way to die if you want. You just hit your head against the wall. Now, I hope this time it will not be, you know, a foreign invader. Huh? What? Travel to the Zone District? Oh, it was actually the second floor? Wait a minute. Now I'm very, very confused. What am I doing over here? Yeah, let's travel to the Zone District. Did I take another wrong... A wrong turn somewhere? Yeah, this is what happens when you speak about all the things in the game but forget to actually where you're going. Well, a good thing this is not a very heavy RPG where you have a lot of decisions and quests and stuff like that. You just have to worry about the demons and, you know, the... Probably the remaining human... Well, there are the human faction, there are the Arisons, which are basically the robots. Well, I don't want to fight those guys again. Seems like this is also a good source of experience because you can just go behind the door and that means they'll respawn. If you, I guess if you go behind this door, they might respawn. And you can just farm those guys over and over and over, and that's 1,600 actions. So that's actually a pretty good location to farm them. Well, at this point you probably need a lot more, but still. I guess it was really on the second floor then. And we had two pathways available to us. Eh, we can't hit our head anymore. Looks so fun. Yeah, we had two pathways. Okay, let's not die. So the burning pipe is actually the location for the weapons. Okay, sorry about the delay, but we'll listen to the other mine. And again, I hope this one is not a demonic invasion. AS. AS sounds like a good name, like an accounting name. Alexata? Body ever? Well, they don't have a body anymore, yes. Yes. He's either an accountant or probably a bureaucrat somewhere. Okay, never reconnected my body. The author tells you. To find the truth. I Atelier, this is the only answers. Okay, thank you. Columns of concentric rings, they must be aligned. Okay, I'll just read the guide because if you want to figure these things out for yourself, it's a lot of work. I'm leave this machine on. Okay, that was nice with a bit of information, so you can find out a lot of lore or hints just by playing the game normally. Ah, so glad to be the pure light again. See you next time, bye!